the zeitgeist narrative, minimalism, the accumulative idea of abstraction. Brian, great waves enriched.
Enduring. Experimental this music.
The melodies.
A special voice.
We experience.
A historical moment.
Bitter-voiced.
Feelings and emotion.
Classic. Minimalist.
Enduring.
Original.
Experimental.
Abstraction.
It's inseparable from the time. After all, this is music we've lived with for 20 years. It's the music that makes it interesting.
You can hear us just for one day.
That hearing this material is a bit like being introduced to a brother or sister that you've been told you had, and you weren't really aware of their existence, and when you do meet them, obviously the very familiarity, the family features sort of register, but there's a whole life and all these things have grown up without you, without your knowledge, and it's sort of, that's a bit like how the music feels. It sort of, it has characteristics that I immediately recognize, but it has its own life. It has nothing to do with me. So Brian particularly deeply indebted to what was happening with new music in Germany at the time, from Dusseldorf and indeed from people as diverse as Edgar Froese to Cannes and all that. And many of them were our friends as well at that time. It's sort of part of whatever community was there, Connie Plank Studio. And
Low Symphony is more of a big structured work, and it is a symphony. And this is very specifically, I think, a ballet, and I almost think of it more of as a suite. The movements are shorter. It's more, I think, a more compact kind of music.
Of course, I had an orchestra. He only had a couple of synthesizers. And it's interesting that David and Brian put... they had a special voice, which I identify with that time. And there was a moment, there was this kind of a precious moment, in a way, when a lot of people working in the field of pop music were beginning to work in a kind of an experimental mode. And you hear it in the music. And what they're doing at that time was very similar to what people working in the avant-garde concert experimental mode were doing. And we were very interested in the same things. Things like multi-tracking. Working in the studio, building pieces together in layers, working with exotic material, as you can hear in this. This is the second one now. We're talking, there will be a third one. I'm now two-thirds through this project. That's how I look at it. The question really is what is a classic? You know, is a classic classical music? Well, obviously it isn't. A classic is what is enduring.
Philip has put more of himself in this new album, but the irony is that I believe that he's actually put his finger on more of my original voice.